Hello guys, do you want to make an app like TikTok? Or do you have an idea for a specific audience like lawyers, coaches, builders, psychologists, teachers, or whoever, and wonder how much does it cost to make an app like TikTok? If you've never done anything like this before, keep watching, because I'll explain the methodology and how to make an app like TikTok step by step. I also reveal the pricing model. You will learn why TikTok clones may cost $500,000, $250,000, or $120,000, and what is the difference, so you can avoid making a deadly mistake in your startup. My name is Dennis Babich, and I'm the founder and CEO of DBT Limited. We are software consultancy and development experts. There are three key elements to TikTok's business model. You have the viewer app for people to watch content creator app, and the admin zone to manage registrations, disputes, payments, and other things. Inside the viewer's app, you have the functions like a content recommendations algorithm, infinity lot, social features like profiles, comments, likes, chats, and so on. I've added these to the table so you can get an idea of the approximate hours your software engineers would need. The content creator section is a completely different animal and has a lot of unique functions like video editing, media library, content distribution algorithm, and so on. Taking a look at the admin zone, you need proper control and management tools within the app, functions like an dashboard, user management, content moderation, dispute handling, and financial management. My team and I know exactly what's needed to make an app like TikTok, and we see many people forgetting to include time for quality assurance, bug fixing, product management, maintenance, and risks. So I wanted to share the actual development hours, rates, and financial prices. Okay, how can you reduce your development expenditures? Let's say you have an investor and a contract requiring an in-house development team. The costs are likely in the line with the US and EU figures. But here's the thing, you could save up to 60% of your development expenditures, create your software in Ukraine. Many startups are getting incredible value by doing this. GitLab, Grammarly, Reface, Jubla, and more are all developed in Ukraine by Ukrainian developers. It just makes sense. Minimum viable product. How TikTok look right now is the result of over 500 people building and improving it since 2012. Replicating their unique matching algorithm could take a year and $500,000 investment. But as you can see, their app was done in stages. Each stage released new functionality and improvements, while the TikTok project grew from a basic MVP to the app we know today. This is why you must launch a rock-solid MVP. Done right, you can test your idea, get your first users, and collect meaningful data and feedback while spending just 120 to 250 grand. Afterwards, you can chase your Series A funding round to take your project to the next level. Okay, so what's needed to build your MVP? There are 10 steps to follow in your development process. It all starts with a lean canvas business plan. Why? Because for any startup to find success, they must find a way to improve the life of their target audience and fulfill their market needs better than any other alternative in the market. Even TikTok itself started against giants like Snapchat, Instagram Stories, and YouTube. That's why it was so important to answer these fundamental questions from day one. Why would a specific blogger with a YouTube channel also start a TikTok channel? What would motivate this action, and what benefits they would get? Why would a specific viewer watch TikTok instead of YouTube or Instagram? What would draw them to this channel over those already in the market? With the lean canvas, you can identify user groups, their pains, and potential solutions, identifying your early adopters and the unique value you bring to beat your competitors and disrupt the market. The lean canvas also helps clarify your unfair advantages and how to monetize your idea. And if you like what you're hearing so far, click the like button and subscribe. Next, we have the value proposition. Your value proposition is the core of your business, an answer to a simple question. for TikTok. It's why users should spend their time in TikTok instead of Instagram or YouTube. Creating a value proposition table helps you to find the right product market fit. TikTok gives value for bloggers, offering a new platform with a unique recommendation algorithm so content creator could appear in top trends regardless of their audience size. Low barriers to entry, no need $2,000 cameras, $500 lightning, video scripts, or a time-consuming video editing process. New content can be created fast, at home, using just your phone. There is an equal opportunity for your videos to quickly and easily reach 1 million views. For viewers, gives the audience abnormally high level of engagement and entertainment compared to any other platform in the space. Instead of waiting for weekly YouTube episodes from a favorite show and smile 6 times in 30 minutes, on TikTok you can watch from 60 to 200 short videos and smile 20 times. TikTok's predictive matching algorithm for video is based on your swipes, trained to show you the videos you might be interested in, so you don't have to wait for days to finally watch another interesting video. Remember playing Mortal Kombat as a kid and the final fatality move? Here is for TikTok. They are already outplaying YouTube. Successful content creators on YouTube are creating reels of their popular shows to re-upload on TikTok and tap into the fast-growing audience. Compiling the juiciest, the funniest, their best moments in a series of 15 to 30 short videos for TikTok audience. So why would anyone who has just watched the highlights go to YouTube to see the full episodes? They already saw the best parts. Fatality. Okay, now I'd like to demonstrate how to use the value proposition in your startup. Let's imagine you're making a TikTok app for psychologists and people who need their help. You will need to learn their wants, their needs, and their pains in order to understand how your TikTok app can meet the business goals of these psychologists. For example, you might discover that many psychologists would like to have a paid subscription service or paid chat or video session functionality, while users may want to record their story in text, audio, or video to get feedback on any concerns or join group video sessions with their spouse and psychologist. The goal is to collect this type of feedback from at least 10 potential clients within each segment of your target audience. This way, you can start to understand the value and relevance of your product, using the value proposition table to identify the real needs in the market, giving you a strong foundation as you bring your project to life. Marketing. Okay, if you're wanted to build an app like TikTok for a psychologist, you should use the following steps to launch the app and get your early adopters onto the platform. First, you should create a list of content creators in the psychology industry, especially those already on TikTok. Then you should pitch them benefits like reaching a new audience, paid subscriptions, the video interface, and so on. Give them a desirable offer that would help them to make a big win. You will gain on experts for your platform as well as their existing audience. Also, hire a marketing expert to conduct target advertising on other social media platforms to attract viewers. Focusing on people who are interested in psychology, relationship, motivation, depression, relationship problems, and so on. Do these two steps and you will quickly make progress and get your first 1000 early adopters. But the competition also plays a role. It's crucial to study the competition and understand how you can outplay their advantage, their existing offers, from the apps who entered the market first. If you are building an app for psychologists and plan to lure viewers and creators from TikTok, you may want to find inspiration in the interface solutions they are familiar with. Giving your app a look that early adopters are used to, as well as services they are already seeing online. This helps them quickly adapt to your platform, while you can copy or create features like quizzes, for investigating psychological issues, uploading therapists' licenses, or booking session calls. Cutting non-essential features like image filters or background music will bring your investment costs down as you develop your MVP. With story mapping, you can quickly select the must-have functions to verify your idea and put your focus on those that can easily be completed and quickly released. Expensive or complicated features that need research and development, like complex video editing or unique algorithms, can be flagged for a later version of your product. Wireframes. Based on the value proposition research, you should create a wireframe map to organize your ideas, decide on a basic flow, and identify any missing user cases. For example, our TikTok app for psychologists will contain basic use cases like sign-up, quiz, feed, subscription, paid therapy session, etc. Missing use cases. For example, a client who has booked and paid for a live video therapy session, but their psychologist already has a session in that time slot from their private practice. So what should happen in this situation? Once you have a clickable UX prototype, you should show it to your early adopters for their feedback and make any necessary changes to the user flow based on the customer's needs. Don't forget to click like and subscribe on the channel. Moving on to UI design. The main goal is to choose the right visual style with a color palette that supports the overall aim of your business. Since you are building a TikTok app for psychologists, you need to choose a soothing colors and tones instead of strong or aggressive branding. This significantly impacts how many times your app will be downloaded, as well as how users will communicate with your app. Once a user clicks your advertisement and reach the App Store, they expect to see a visual style they can associate with your app. It's critical that you choose the right name that's easily spelled and it's different to any existing app names. Design a logo and icon that your users can quickly associate with your app. Upload eye-catching covers to highlight the app's functionality and biggest benefits. Before starting any development, you need to be sure of two things: how you plan to grow the app and the underlying technology stack. Getting these right will save you lots of money on cloud infrastructure and ongoing product maintenance. Our recommendation is to follow a monolith project structure in the beginning to launch your MVP and get real feedback from the market. This can reduce your software development costs up to 40%. If you were building a TikTok app for psychologists, a smart technology stack would be native Swift for iOS and Kotlin for Android. You can use existing open source modules for video feed, messaging, voice calls, and easily modify them to your needs. Python, Django, or Node.js for the backend infrastructure. Similar to Swift and Kotlin, there are many open source modules you can easily modify to suit your needs. Pro tip: keep in mind that using a sophisticated technology like Ruby, Java, or Scala creates a real risk. If you lose a developer midway through, you may be forced to put your project on hold for 6 to 12 months until you can hire an engineer at the same level. The smart move is building your product fast and cheap to confirm your expectations match reality. If the app marketable and that there is a profit potential. After launching the MVP, you will gain three important insights from your target audience. Any bottlenecks in the process, inconsistent or slow user flows, new use cases needed additional work, for example, age limit or sensitive content, useless functionality that can be eliminated. At this stage, you can start transitioning from a monolith project structure to a microservice-based architecture and convert each complex feature into its own microservice. This can make a project run 10 to 100 times faster. When you start a project, it's important to achieve fast development on a low budget. But once you switch to more complicated tasks, you need a different technology stack, a stack that will allow you to reach more advanced goals in your environment and infrastructure setup. As an example, more advanced tasks might be: create a self-sufficient machine learning microservice to automatically review and filter sensitive content using C++, or improve video upload speed and quality by compiling and configuring a FFmpeg library for mobile development. Once you reach this stage, the value of your startup can increase from $10 to $50 million, based on four important factors: your audience and existing traffic, your product market fit, your unique private algorithms that you can patent, your team of experienced IT engineers. The software development approach is different from a classic business model, because you need to consistently update your app to satisfy the fast-changing needs of the market. The key benefit of an agile development process is speed, being able to quickly adapt your product to fit the needs of your market. But agile can also lower your overall impact level up to 30%, so it's incredibly important to have proper management tools during the growth of your app. For a small team building the MVP, let's say you have a team of 4 to 6 developers. Each will understand their own tasks and communication points. As it's still a small app, any developer will be able to easily make updates to the app, because they will have a deep knowledge of the full project. This is why simple project management tools are effective at this stage. Trello, Asana, Google Docs, short meetings, and weekly reports on delivery are enough to effective communication. Implementing more complex software or Scrum sessions in the early stages create unnecessary bureaucracy, while wasting 30% of your developers' time on this. For a big team building product, once the project is gaining traction, you're attracting funding, and the team is growing, you need more robust solution for agile management. Because at this stage, you will face a number of problems. Your current developers may leave the team. Onboarding new developers become increasingly complex. No one knows their responsibility in the project. Productivity rates are falling in your development team. There is a lack of synchronization between developers. You face constant delivery and deadline issues. To solve these issues, you can take the following actions: assign a tech lead to oversee the team, hire a project manager to oversee the project, implement Scrum, sprints, backlog, retrospective, organize daily stand-up meetings with work reports, implement advanced task management tools like Jira or Asana. And remember, once you've done all this, you can't forget the analytics. Analytics tools like Firebase, AppFlyer, Adjust, AppMetric, Amplitude, and Flurry allow you to measure how your app is performing, measuring the number of visits, user behaviors, monitoring and analyzing user sessions, and much more. These tools give you the data your business needs to make the right decisions throughout the software development process and get real-time health check into your product or service. Creating an app can be a big project, but with the right approach, you can set yourself up for success. If you are interested in making an app like TikTok, click the link below and book a 15-minute call with me, and let's talk about turning your business idea into a winner. See ya!